Hello friends, in this review, we will talk about a controllable ceiling light from the well-known and beloved brand Acura. This is the junior version of the T1M series with a power of 32 watts, and there is also a 40-watt model with similar functionality. The ceiling light is suitable for lighting small living rooms, and thanks to its addressable color backlight, it can also serve as an atmospheric light, a night light, and be used for light notifications. More details will be covered later in my review, but for now, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video so more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device, ceiling light. Model, Acura T1M 32 watts. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Main lighting, white light, color temperature from 2700 to 6500 Kelvin, color rendering index of at least 90. Side backlight, color addressable strip, lifespan, no less than 50,000 hours. Operating voltage range, 100 to 240 volts. Temperature range, from minus 10 to 40 degrees Celsius. Dimensions, 395 by 80 millimeters. The ceiling light comes in the usual recycled cardboard box for the Chinese versions. For the global versions, they use bright color printing. On one of the sides, the list of parameters that I just mentioned is indicated. What else can I add? The 40-watt version for the Chinese market contains the number 12 instead of 11, while for the global market, it is called CL-L02D. This is how the ceiling light is positioned inside the box. It is protected from damage by two inserts made of shockproof material. And I must say, they protect it well. Everything arrived intact and undamaged. In addition to the ceiling light, the package also includes a small manual and mounting hardware for installation. The manual is designed for the internal market, so it is in Chinese. The main lighting is provided by 48 diodes, 24 warm and 24 cool. In the warmest mode, only the yellow diodes are on, while in the coolest mode, the white ones are lit. In intermediate modes, the brightness of each varies depending on the set temperature. The LED driver operates via Zigbee. It's quite unusual as it controls both the two channels of white light and the color backlight strip at the same time. Essentially, it's two devices in one, or even three if you count the fact that it also serves as a power supply unit. Six wires lead from it to the main panel with the diodes. Three are needed for controlling the panel, a common positive and negatives for the warm and cool channels. The other three go to the addressable strip. This includes 12-volt power and a data bus. The strip runs around the entire perimeter of the ceiling light, with a slight overlap. Using addressable diodes not only reduces the number of required contacts, since regular diodes need a separate one for each color channel and a common positive, but also allows independent control of each diode. For even light diffusion, the side of the light cover, like the front, is made of semi-transparent matte plastic. The back of the ceiling light has three mounting holes. Acura hasn't yet added a convenient removable mounting plate like some Yeelight models have, which is a shame since it makes installation and replacing old models with new ones much easier. To connect the ceiling light, it needs to be powered by live and neutral wires, with grounding being optional. I'd like to clarify that control devices are designed to stay permanently connected to the power grid, and if you use regular switches, the ceiling light will go offline when turned off. I plan to use it with a switch from the same manufacturer that doesn't require a neutral wire, naturally in a mode where the switch buttons are decoupled from the relay. To ensure stable operation, I installed a capacitor. More details on this can be found in my video, link in the description. I connected the phase and neutral wires, but did not use the grounding. The terminal block is very convenient. Each contact allows for connecting two wires, and the fastening is done using a clamp. I will begin the logical part with the standard control system. Acura Home, region set to mainland China. The gateway in use is Acura M2, with the latest firmware version. I go into the mode for adding new devices and select the ceiling light from the list in the lighting section. To put it into pairing mode, you need to turn it off and on 5 times, after which the main light will switch to breathing mode. The ceiling light then connects to the gateway. For each of the lights, the main and side one, you can choose a separate name and icon. Physically, it's one device, but logically, from the system's perspective, these are two separate lights. the system notified me of an available firmware update. For Zigbee devices, this process can be quite lengthy because the network speed is slow. You'll have to wait quite a while. On the main device's screen, two separate lights are displayed, but the plugin is shared and has individual tabs for the main and side lights. On the first tab, there is a general switch for both lights, as well as a separate one for the main light. The main light only operates in white mode with adjustable color temperature. Control is via two channels, cold and warm light diodes. The diodes in each channel are synchronized and have the same brightness. The side light provides colored lighting, which can be either static, where all the diodes shine in one color with uniform brightness, or dynamic, featuring effects like running lights, gradients, fragment flickering, and so on. If desired, both lights can be used simultaneously, but for the side light to be visible against the main one, it needs to operate at a low brightness. The main light tab includes effects such as preset brightness and temperature modes, a breathing mode that can be used as a notification, and the ability to set gradual on and off transitions for comfortable waking and sleeping. Brightness and temperature can also be adjusted manually, and frequently used settings can be saved. Both the main and side lights can be grouped with other lights. The side light tab works similarly, offering a selection of preset dynamic effects and static color settings from a palette or spectrum. There is also an effect builder, allowing you to choose the type of motion, sequence, and speed of color transitions. White light mode. You can adjust the color temperature from cool to warm and back. Fade effect. Breathing mode. This is how the dynamic effects look on the side light. In the General Settings menu, you can find several useful options. You can configure the behavior after power is restored, always on, always off, or remember the state before power was lost. There are settings for smooth brightness transitions when turning the light on or off, and these parameters can be configured separately. You can adjust the dimming scale so that brightness doesn't drop below or exceed a set limit. As is typical for Zigbee devices, there is also a signal quality monitor. In automations, the ceiling light can work as a trigger by responding to on and off events, or as a condition by checking whether it is on or off. In actions, there are many more options, especially since the system treats it as two separate lights. You can turn them on, off, set brightness, and adjust lighting parameters. Some actions are only available when using logical dimmers or the cube, so if they're not set as triggers, those actions won't be selectable. Besides brightness, color temperature, and color, you can trigger light effects through automations, which allows you to use the device for notifications and reminders. Since this gateway is connected to Apple HomeKit, let's check compatibility, which is, by the way, officially supported. The ceiling light is recognized, and by default, both lights are shown in one tile, but in the settings, you can separate them into different tiles. Control over the lights is standard, on A off, brightness scale, and parameter control. For the main light, you can adjust the color temperature, and for the side light, you can select the color. Dynamic effects, however, are not available here and are only accessible via the Acura Home app. But in HomeKit, the ceiling light can interact with devices from other manufacturers added to the system. Continuing with compatibility testing, I switched the Acura Home app to the European server. Here, I am using the E1 gateway with the latest firmware at the time of the test. At first glance, the model appears to be supported, but as it turns out, only the 40-watt version is. The global version is definitely supported, but as for the Chinese version, that remains unclear. The 32-watt version for the China region is not supported. Now, let's check if the light can be connected to Mi Home. I have the China mainland region selected, using the third-generation gateway with the latest firmware. This particular ceiling light model is not listed among the devices, though the L1350 version is available. You can find a review of it via the link in the description. I selected it since it's mainly for putting the gateway into pairing mode, and if the device is supported, it would connect. But in this case, the T1M32W model is not supported in Mi Home. There's no point in testing the Europe region. Now, let's check the ceiling light's functionality in the local smart home management center, Sunoff iHost. You can learn more about it in my reviews, link in the description. The firmware version at the time of testing is 2.2.0. The iHost has its own Zigbee coordinator, allowing it to control devices with this interface directly, provided they are supported by the system. The correct icon appearing on the ceiling lights tile after pairing was initially very encouraging. Unfortunately, beyond the icon, there was nothing else. On this firmware version, the ceiling light is not supported in iHost. It's possible that the 40-watt version is supported, which is why the icon was loaded, but I can't say for sure. Another option is to use the ceiling light via the standard Acura M2 gateway, which we previously discussed, and Home Assistant using the Matter protocol. In this case, both Acura Home and Apple HomeKit can be used simultaneously. The gateway, which is the first on the list, operates in Zigbee to Matter bridge mode, transferring connected devices to third-party systems. In this case, Home Assistant. Six entities appeared, both the main and side lights, brightness levels when each is turned on, and settings for behavior after power restoration. The main light can be turned on and off, and you can adjust its brightness and color temperature. The side light allows control over brightness and static colors. Just like in Apple HomeKit, dynamic effects are not available. Now let's test compatibility with a direct Zigbee connection. This is through the native ZHA integration, using a USB stick with SkyConnect firmware. The link to the review, as usual, is in the description below the video. By the way, if the ceiling light is disconnected from its previous coordinator or gateway, it will immediately enter pairing mode and can be picked up by a new coordinator without the need to toggle it on and off 5 times. In ZHA, the ceiling light is supported, and both the main and side lights appeared with many different settings. The main light allows for brightness and color temperature adjustment. The side light offers only static lighting settings without dynamic effects. Additional settings are duplicated for each light and concern smooth on and off transitions and initial lighting settings. As of the testing date, there is no option for behavior after power restoration. The default mode is for both the main and side lights to turn on when power is restored, which is not very convenient. You'll need to use workarounds, such as automations that check whether the ceiling light was turned on via the switch rather than on its own. The final test is compatibility with Zigbee 2 MQTT, with the latest version at the time of testing being 1.40.2. I activated the pairing mode for new devices and removed the ceiling light from ZHA. The device entered pairing mode and was recognized by the Zigbee 2 MQTT coordinator. Support is built in, and no additional converters were needed. The ceiling light functions as a router in the network, meaning it relays data for other nodes. The only issue is that the model number is listed as the 40-watt version. On the device exposure page, additional options were found, such as the number of power outages, device temperature, and memory for the state after power loss. You can control both lights, turning them on and off, adjusting brightness, color temperature, and color. However, effects are not available. The biggest downside is the lack of true state memory. I checked the project discussions on GitHub, and there's information indicating that this mode is implemented differently from other Acura ceiling lights, which is why the standard method doesn't work. I hope this issue will be addressed eventually. This is how the device looks in Home Assistant through the MQTT integration. The lights are labeled as white and RGB by default. There are no issues with turning the lights on and off, adjusting brightness, color temperature, and static colors, but the absence of state memory management is quite disappointing. I really like the ceiling light, and it's suitable for rooms of up to about 10 square meters. If the room is larger, the brightness may not be sufficient. The side backlight expands its functionality, allowing it to be used as a nightlight, ambient lighting, or for light notifications. Currently, it's best to use it in Home Assistant through the native gateway with Matter support, as this at least enables state memory and allows limited use of dynamic effects alongside Home Assistant's automations. However, if you don't have such a gateway, be prepared for the lights to turn on after power restoration. I hope this issue will be resolved, especially since discussions mention that it's already been addressed for ZHA, though the feature wasn't yet available during the testing. I would also love to see at least some preset dynamic effects in alternative systems. That's all for now, and I hope you found this video helpful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes, as they help the video reach more people on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications. In the description, you'll find all the links mentioned, stores, other videos on this topic, my Telegram channels, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home questions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time, and peace to everyone.